Was the Chinese transgression of the line of actual control, or the LAC, in Tawang sector of Arunachal Pradesh on the 9th of December part of Beijing's fairly new strategy to alter the status quo along the border? Well, all assessments indicate that the People's Liberation Army of China, or the PLA, has been asked by the Chinese establishment to adopt an aggressive posturing along the LAC in a bid to alter the accepted or perceived border between the two Asian giants. In fact, in a recent interview, former Army Chief General MM Naravane called this salami-cutting tactic whereby Beijing could try to alter the LAC in small incremental steps over a period of time. Now, it is clear that the PLA infantry may have gathered the courage to try and transgress the LAC in Tawang sector because of the massive Chinese air power buildup in the Tibet Xinjiang region since the last couple of years. The Center for Strategy and International Studies, an American think tank, has said in a recent report that China has built 9 new airports in the Tibet region, which are run by the PLA aviation wing. Reports accessed show that China has built 4 new airports and 5 new heliports in Tibet along the border with India, while upgrading 5 airports and 2 heliports. Reports talk about sighting of fighter aircrafts, refuelers, airborne early warning and control aircrafts, and the sophisticated WZ-7 called Soaring Dragons at some of the air bases within a distance of 150 kilometers from Arunachal Pradesh. And these drones, launched about a year ago, are said to have a capability to fly non-stop up to 10 hours. The air power buildup by Chinese indicate that they were engaged in serious airspace surveillance along the Sino-Indian border. Significantly, the Chinese are even militarizing the civilian airports in the area. For example, the Ningxi Mainland Airport, not far from the border in Arunachal Pradesh, has seen militarization since 2020. In some of these air bases, reports talk about sighting of military training and air defense equipment besides camouflage positions. Obviously, one can safely say that the Indian military establishment is aware of these developments across the border. Whether or not the Indian Air Force's exercises over the Arunachal skies and India's decision to launch combat air patrol in the area are the result of the preparedness across the border is something that should be left to the Indian defense establishment to comment upon. Now, Northeast Life Chief of Bureau Arindam Das spoke to Strategic and Defense Affairs Analyst Colonel retired Dibya Shankar Bhattacharya on the developments. Well, Colonel Bhattacharya said and spoke about the possible reasons for the fresh escalation bid by China. Listen in.
We are joined in by Colonel Dibya Shankar Bhattacharya. Well, there are reports of massive buildup by China in the Tibetan frontier, close to the LAC in Arunachal Pradesh, where there are reports that in the air bases they have kept WZ-7 UAVs, yes, which have high capabilities, which are advanced. So what are they up to? I mean, what is the misadventure they are planning?
Basically, as you see, China has got 3 areas of interest. The first area is, of course, the capture of Taiwan. The second area is the South China Sea. And third is the border conflict with India. Out of these, the capture of Taiwan and that the control over the South China Sea is ridden with certain difficulties because of the involvement of the Americans and the Western Alliance. However, the Chinese leadership at this point of time thinks that the conflict with India can be resolved on their terms and condition. And that is this wrong thinking is the basis for the misadventure which I would say has come on December 9th when they tried to capture one of our posts in the Tawang sector.
And Colonel Bhattacharya, however, maintained that despite Chinese efforts, India still enjoys the advantage of air power along the LAC.
How do you see the placement of advanced UAVs like WZ7, which are called soaring dragons, and in fact they have also placed a prototype of a Russian Su-30 MKI, which they have now made it into flanker type aircraft. So how do you see this?
Technologically, they are slightly, they have got slightly more advanced aircrafts and drones in certain areas. As far as the drone you are mentioning, I would like to say that we have also got drones of a similar capability. The only thing is that in China, there is a mass production, the numbers are more, but we are catching up. And I'm sure within a short time, we will be able to match China in every aspect. India has got a great advantage in that the Indian Air Force bases are much nearer to the border than China. China, as you can see, most of their population and most of their towns and cities are towards the eastern part of China. In fact, Beijing is almost 4,500 kilometers from here. Therefore, but the Indian, major Indian air bases, it is almost near the border. Therefore, the takeoff time, as far as India is concerned, is much lesser. This gives us a much better advantage. Secondly, the induction of the Rafale and other aircrafts has also given additional strength to the Indian Air Force. However, as far as India is concerned, I feel that there is a requirement for mass induction of more drones, especially in the light of the war which we are seeing in Russia versus Ukraine, and also earlier the results of the Armenia and Azerbaijan conflict, in which drones played a great role. The next aspect which I would like to highlight is that India has to now go in for armed drones, because this is one area which I feel will help India to counter Chinese armed drones.